Starting November 1st, Kittl made top AI models free. And here are the 7 things you can do within minutes before the poll runs out. And if you get any value out of this video, all I ask is you smash that like button. Let's get into it.
Okay, so now what we're going to do is generate, so text to image, we're gonna go ahead and generate an image. I'm gonna come over here, generate images, I'm gonna click that. And it's gonna bring us over here into the Kittl editor, right? And we're gonna use the nano banana for this example. You can see how I click, there's a few different models that you can choose down here. I'm hitting nano banana. And then I have a prompt idea already. I do create a lot of prompt ideas on my channel. So if you're unaware of that, I do have a ton of prompt ideas that I'd like to share on here to help you guys understand, you know, how prompts work, right? It's a big thing right now. And then you can click on the styles. You can choose styles. You can choose the sizing, private or public. And then you can choose how many images you want to do. So for this example, we're going to just go ahead and hit the generate. And it's generating this little image right here for us. Okay, and you can see how I'm just resizing it, right? See how user-friendly it is? It's really cool. It's just one of the coolest things, okay? And it did a pretty good job. Now, look at, so I created this image right here. And then we're going to go ahead and just say, for example, we want to remove this background, right? So you can remove the background if you want to. And then let's go ahead and generate another image. Now, there's a little eraser tool too as well. So if you have to clean up any of the background, you can definitely do so by hitting this a little eraser, but pretty user-friendly as far as like removing the background. You can see how fast it does it. Look at that. Did a really good job. Okay. Now, just keep in mind with different AI images, there's more detail, right? It's an, some things it's not going to catch, but for the most part, if you can edit the prompt tool as well, where you say plain black background, just little things you can add to the prompt to help it generate an image to make it plain as possible, you can definitely do that. But there's a little tool, eraser tool in here, and you can adjust it too. And then you can do a little bit of erasing inside of here if you want to. Cool feature. I love creating text to images, right? And then it creates these really cool graphics, as you can see, that you can use, and you can use it for t-shirt designs or whatever product you're designing for. All right, next is the Vectorize tool back here. So we're going to convert an image to a scalable vector art. So we're going to come over here. And as we try now, it's going to go ahead and load up. It says upload or drop. So drop and paste your PNG or JPEG. Okay, we're going to upload. I'm going to select an image. I'm going to go ahead and select this one. Now, to be optimistic, like, just try to keep it between 2 to 5. This one right here, I'm just doing it for this test to see, like, and tell you, show you how good it does, right? So I'm just going to hit vectorize. You can click it over here on the right side too as well. But I'm gonna hit vectorize, and it's gonna read it too, by the way. So it already knows like how many colors are in the image, which is really cool. I'm gonna go ahead and put it all the way up to 16, and we'll go ahead and vectorize the image. You see how fast it did it, right? So look how cool this is. It got the whole image for us. Now you're gonna see on the right-hand side over here, right? You're gonna see all the different colors it did for us. So we can literally, if I wanted to take out all the colors, I can do that if I wanted to. You can see what I'm doing, right? So you can edit any of this. And then let's bring a ball back in. You can change any of the colors, which is really cool. Let me move myself over here so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. You can come over here to browse the color palettes, and then you can mess with any of these, right? And it just puts it in there for you. See exactly what I'm doing. Just going over and hovering over it. It's just changing the color. Pretty cool, huh? If you wanted to change like the, let's say just like the, if you just wanted to change just one random color, you can do that too. So you can see how powerful it is, how you can adjust certain things. It can take off the color in a certain part of the graphic, and it vectorizes the whole image for us. And you can obviously scale it however you want to as well. Okay. Really cool feature when it comes to the vectorize tool. Now, what we're going to do is going to go ahead and go into Kittl Flows and trial a smart board. So now what I like to do personally is I'm going to come over here to a new project. So let's say that you're going to go ahead and take a design and you want to scale it out. Okay, that's the main idea. So I do a lot of print on demand content on this channel. So as far as merch by Amazon or Amazon merch on demand, I'm going to go ahead and click here. It gives me the template and exact dimension. You can also to come over here and to try Kittl Flows, and then it will take you through like the whole process, and it will show you exactly how to do it, give you an idea when it loads up. You're going to see right here, just breaks it all down for you if you want to check that and look into the more detail right there. So for example, let's go ahead and just stay with this little guy right here, right? We're going to go ahead and click right in that area. You can see how I highlighted the actual whole canvas and the whole artboard, right? And then we're going to hit add smart board. And then the model that I'm using, you're going to see, you can select the model right here. I'm going to use the nano banana. Say I want to change Okay, let's test that out. Now let's go ahead and create another one. So we can add another smart board. Let's say we don't want it to say 6. We want to change it to 8. It's just an example, okay? Hit generate. Now look what it did with it. We got our turkey. And it got the Santa theme on still, right? Which is really cool. You see exactly what it did. So it took our concept, our idea, our main idea, and then we just dragged it along here, okay? So we have another one. And then it did the same thing, how it changed the 9 to the 8. And this is how you would create like a scalable design. So you just take in the whole concept and then you can literally just go down a whole rabbit hole and create another 10 different ideas. So if you don't want 9, 8, you can change 7, 8. And then you want to go back to 6, 7, you can change 6, 7. If you want an elf, okay, we can do that instead of Santa. We can do an elf, okay? Then instead of Santa, do a reindeer. You see what I'm doing? Deer, okay? That's a cool one, see? And you're just going down a whole rabbit hole of creating and scaling out different designs. And there's a reindeer. You can do a ton of stuff with this right here, which is really cool. So just scaling it all out, right? You can see that. All right. So the next is typography lockup. I want you to keep in mind, like this one right here. So the text is live. You can see like I'm hovering over it. Little things right here, like I can edit any of this. Okay, there's a ton of them in the back end as far as like the templates, the different templates that you can come in, any of this right here. So any of this text is, you can edit any of this text if you're looking for inspiration or you like the idea, the concept, the layout, you can switch it to whatever you like. So for example, so if I click on this, I want to just switch out the text, right? Instead of overthinking solves nothing but never thinking, and then I hit boom. It goes in, never thinking, it solves nothing, okay? And then as I say, if I wanted to change the date right there, I can do that. I can edit any of this, and then I can highlight it all too as well if I wanted to scale it, which is really cool. So, and then I can position any of this. That's one of the most popular features inside of Kittl, as you can see how the text, the typography lock is like, the text and everything is still live on the back end. I think when it comes to this, the editing features with the fonts or just the different layouts, the typography, all the different text, stuff like that. It's very powerful. And then you can see how I use leverage it with smart boards to create different mockups too. We're going to get into that more, but that's a really cool feature. Okay, next we're going to test out two of the newest models, and I'm going to come over here to generate images. Okay. And I'm going to have some prompts that we're going to use over here. So we're going to come over here to the left side right here. So there's different models that you can choose from, but the ones that we're going to test is Nano Banana. So we're going to go ahead and go with that. The prompt I put in and then generate an image. Okay. And let that generate. And then we'll go ahead and grab another prompt idea. And then I'm going to go ahead and put that in there and generate. So you see exactly what it did there. It generated two images for us. And then we're going to come over here to the Sea Dream. So these are two are Nano Banana, just to give an example. And then we'll come over here to Sea Dream 4. And then we're going to go ahead and add in another generate. So it's generating there. This is our art board too. So we'll just drag the image over there if you need to. And then we'll go ahead and grab another prompt idea when that one's done. Just go ahead and test these out. Just give you an idea of how these work. My favorite one is this little cute little ghost. So we'll try him and C-Dude too as well. So this little pickleball ghost, right? And let that generate in Sea Dream 4. But you can see, you know, how it's generating these images pretty fast and let you be the judge as far as what's your favorite image by using Sea Dream 4 and then Nano Banana. But it's really cool that we know how you can just look at all these different models that we're using. But so this is Nano Banana, and this is Sea Dream. Out of all of them we created, this one's my favorite, but this one's not bad at all. This one's okay, depending what you're doing. But for the example, when I compare them all, me personally, this will be 1. This will probably be 2. This one will probably be 3. And then 5. This one's, I don't think it's okay. But yeah, that's how you comparing Sea Dream 4, the newest models, and then Nano Banana inside of Kittl. All right, so another cool feature, I'm gonna go ahead and show you what we're gonna do is come over here to new project. We're gonna just change the colors of the different Santa. So got this Santa right here, right? We're gonna go ahead and click on the board. We're gonna go ahead and duplicate it. So as we duplicate it, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit so I'll give you an idea. We're just gonna go ahead and vectorize. Then we can duplicate another one if we wanted to. Okay, let's say we wanna just browse the color palettes and we wanted to change it to, okay, we want that color right there. All right. We can go ahead and if we want to duplicate it again, say we wanted to do another color, we can do that too. Click on that. We'll go ahead and vectorize that one too. So this one, you can do with the color palettes too, like I showed you, or you can just come over here to all the other colors, right? So if we want to change the ice cream cone, right? So if you want to change the ice cream cone to like a different color, we can do so. We want to change it. Okay. Mess around with the color a bit if you want to. Just an example. Okay. So that's cool. Okay. Keep it like that. Now we want to say we want to add it to a mockup. Watch this. It's pretty cool. There it is. Now this is for if you're creating something. Let's think about it as you have your brand on social media and you're trying to advertise a new t-shirt. This would be a good way to do that. Okay. And this you can literally just click on this one. Say that you're okay. You're happy with that. You can see how I did that. I can literally just hit quick export and then I can just download it. Then it'll go into my PC. Boom, it's downloaded. See how fast that was? And there it is. Bam. You can upload it to your PC. Now let's say we want to grab this one and we want to add another mockup, right? But we don't want that one. We want to do, and there's a ton of them that you can choose from. So let's just type in t-shirt for this example. Let's use that one. Let's zoom back in. Okay. Bam. Okay, click on it. You can download it right there. Same exact thing. Okay. So you can see how cool and easy it is to download. And then if you want to get a little bit more detail with the download, when you download, you can select whatever you want. You can select anything here. If you want to download it in a PNG, JPEG, SVG, or a PDF file, you can definitely select that, remove the background, optimize for quality, and hit download, and boom. Now, the final thing I want to talk about is the exporting features, okay? So if I want to click on that, click on the image, I can quick export here, okay? And then you can see like the different sizes, and then you can choose right here, PNG, JPEG, SVG, PDF. Now it's really cool because it's like you click on it. If you have a lot of graphics on the screen, you can literally just click and download as is. Now also too, you come up here into the right-hand corner, right? This is very convenient. Depending on what you're doing, you can change the sizing of everything over here, pixel, inches, and then the same thing here too as well. PNG, JPEG, SVG, PDF, and then you can change the DPI however you like it, and then remove the background, optimize quality. But it's really convenient depending on what you're doing. If you're uploading to a certain platform, so I do a lot of Amazon merch on demand. I'm doing the 4500 by the 5400. Okay, that's what I'm usually doing right there. And then I would remove the background and hit download. Okay, so that's what I usually do as far as getting my designs up to certain platforms and doing it that way. And you can see how I downloaded it. Very convenient. It goes onto your computer. But if you need it in a different format, so say if you know you need a JPEG, you can do that too as well. Okay, if you need an SVG, you can do that as well. And then if you need it in a PDF, you can do that as well. All right, you can see how fast I pretty much did everything, right? Which is really cool. So I think when it comes to any of this stuff, depending on what you're going to use it for, I think this is a really awesome way to leverage Kittl. This tool comes in clutch for all of those things, how you can scale out everything and how you can create images and how you can do everything pretty much when it comes to an all-in-one design tool.
I hope these 7 tips and tricks helped you with understanding Kittl a bit more and you grow your business and make money, because that is the main goal with me creating this video for you. And if you want weekly tips and tricks, make sure you subscribe with notification bells on. Smash that like button. If you have any questions or concerns, leave a comment down below. I'll answer it. And if you want to see how you create a trending AI design with Kittl, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.